Hi, see you in 1 minute. Okay, guys. We're going to start with our class. Thank you for coming on time. Thank you. This is nice. We're going to start. Hi, Joanna. Welcome back.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, bienvenida de regreso, Joanna.
Thank you. I'm so sorry. I was in troubles.
Oh, okay, but you're fine now? You're
yes.
Okay? Excellent,
yes.
Glad to hear that. Now, let's go ahead and call the attendance. Give me a moment. I'm gonna have to use something else. One moment, guys. Sometimes, you know, computers, they don't want to work at all. So it takes a while. A veces las computadoras no quieren funcionar y toman un poquitín de tiempo y trabajan como se debe. Pero, we have here everyone. Okay, I have Ana Alicia Valle de Molina. Ana Alicia. Brenda y Emilia Estrada Torres.
Presente.
Cecilia Beatriz del Carmen Cepeda Soto. Daniela María Ramos Ramos. Edwin Leonel Ordóñez Velázquez.
Presente.
Edwin. Fátima presente. Joana Tejada Candelario.
Presente, teacher.
Thank you. Gerardo Antonio Colocho Cordero.
Presente, dicho.
Thank you. Aide de la Paz Santos Vázquez. Aide de la Paz. Jair Adonis Martín Molina. Jair Adonis. Juana Cristela Euseda García. Jonathan Alexis González Torres. Karen Janet Cruz Valiente.
Presente.
Carla Susana Mena Valencia. Katia Carolina Parada Trejo.
Presente.
Marina Vanessa Vázquez Romero.
Presente.
Miriam Arelí Romero Luna. Sandra Marisela Cepeda Alfaro.
I'm here.
Teresa de Jesús Ramos Santos. Teresa. Verónica Esmeralda Martínez Dueñas.
Presente.
Thank you, Verónica. Welcome back. Now we're going to start, we're going to continue here with our class. Let me delete this information. Okay, perfect. Now, last class, we were working with have to and need to. In today's class, class number 9, nuestra clase número 9, se trata de have to and need to practice. Now tell me, when am I going to use have to? ¿Cuándo voy a utilizar have to? ¿Cuándo utilizo have to? Dígame, Katia. Have to. ¿Quién se recuerda? ¿Quién me le quiere ayudar a Katia? Yo sé que se acuerda, pero no se acuerda ahorita.
El have to es cuando yo tengo que hacer una acción o cuando, digamos, yo tengo que hacer una exigencia. No necesito realmente algo, sino que debo de hacerlo.
Exacto, no necesito, sino que debo de. Exactamente, esa es la palabra. ¿Qué hay de need to, Sandra Marisela? ¿Qué se recuerda de need to? ¿Cuándo lo voy a utilizar? ¿Por qué? ¿Para qué? ¿De qué me sirve? ¿Por qué no estamos tomando el tiempo de estudiar?
Cuando se necesita algo.
Ok. Cuando se necesita algo. ¿Se necesita algo o se necesita realizar una acción?
Realizar una acción.
Exactamente. Cuando hay una necesidad. Right? O cuando no hay necesidad también, porque lo podemos ocupar en negativo. Right? Very good. So we have there, right? What we're going to start working with. Right? Last week, la semana pasada, hicimos nuestros ejemplos, right? Con el negativo y el positivo. But today, I want you to go ahead and practice with me with have to, has to, right? Look at this, right? It says, fill in the blanks with have to, has to, don't have to, and doesn't have to. For example, vamos a hacer esto acá. We have first one. Okay, the first one says, Mary can't go to the cinema. Mary can go to the cinema. She look after her sister tonight. Now, what do I have to choose? Have to, has to, don't have to, or doesn't have to. Mary can't go to the cinema. She look after her sister. What?
Has to.
Excellent. She has to look after her sister. Very well. Let me put it bigger and with negrita. She has to look after her sister tonight. Thank you, Anna. Now, let's go ahead and do number 2. Karen Janet.
Hi, teacher. I'm here. Sorry.
Hi, Aide. Okay. It says, my parents can't go to Italy. They work this summer. What do you think is the answer?
Have to.
They have to. Excellent. They have to, right? Oops. They have to work the summer, right? It's an obligation. It's an obligation. Now let's try to do the others. Let's try to do the others. Vamos a hacer todas esas, right? Have to. has to, do not have to, and doesn't have to. Right? ¿Se entiende cómo vamos a trabajar en estos momentos?
¿Sí? Yes, teacher.
Okay, very good. Let's do it individually, please. Welcome, Ana. Welcome, Aide. Welcome, Jair. Welcome, Euseda. Okay. Díganme si tienen preguntas del vocabulario. Sé que hay unas palabritas nuevas por ahí. Así que díganme si tienen preguntas. No questions? Tell me if you have questions.
Mami,
No.
Teacher.
Yes.
One question in number 8. What is the meaning of carry?
Carry. For example, right now I am carrying my notebooks. Carrying. Cargar. Carrying. Sometimes okay. You carry babies.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome, Karen. Another question?
Mommy.
Did you finish?
No.
No?
No. Thank you. you have to, has to.
Ready, teacher.
Excellent.
My father.
2 more minutes so we can start work.
Okay. My father, it is an important expert manager. He traveled around.
Teacher, uh-huh. One question, yes. Number 11, the ironing.
Ironing, for example, where is my iron? Iron is, for example, with the clothes, right? When you have to go to the office, you have your clothing, you have to iron your clothing, so it looks neat, right? It looks like this. If you don't iron the clothing, it will look wrinkled, right? So iron means planchar.
Planchar? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Hacer el planchado. Ah, está bien, Ana. Ana has an iron. That is an iron. You use the iron for ironing. Thank you, Anna. I don't know where my iron is. I think it's in my bedroom. Okay, now let's continue. Number three. Number three, Aide, what's the answer? My friends. Aide de la Paz.
My friend don't have to get up early tomorrow because it's Sunday.
Because it's Sunday. My friends don't have to get up early tomorrow because it's Sunday. Thank you. Anna, Caroline.
Doesn't have to clean her car today because it's raining.
Doesn't have to, very good. Doesn't have to clean her house today because it's raining, her car. Number five, Vanessa, alias Marina. Children. Marina.
Aquí voy. I don't know, but children. Esa no la había hecho, teacher.
Okay, don't worry. Gerardo is going to help you. Gerardo.
Thank you.
The children. No estoy seguro, pero yo le he colocado children have to work. No, perdón. Children don't have to work. First, they have to go to school.
Children don't have to work. First, they have to go to school. Children is plural. Child is singular. One child, three children. Very good. Thank you so much, Gerardo. Vanessa, Veronica, number six.
Peter have to, no, perdón. Sorry, I can't come tomorrow. I have to go to the doctors.
I have to go to the doctors. Very good. I have to go to the doctors. Excellent. Number seven, Jair, Peter. Adonis. Se fue Adonis otra vez. Okay, Brenda.
Peter has to read a lot of books because he's studied literature.
Peter has to read a lot of books because he's studying literature. Very good. Number 8, Karen Janet.
Okay. The woman doesn't have to carry all those bags. Her husband can help her.
Her husband can help her. There you go. She doesn't have to carry all those bags. Great. Good, Karen. Let's see number 9, Elcera. Será?
You have to. You have to get up early tomorrow if you want to be there at 7.
Okay, very good. Thank you so much. Just give me one moment, guys. Un segundito. Okay, I'm sorry, guys. Let's check in here. Edwin Leonel, number 10. My father.
Yes, teacher. My father is an import export manager. He has to travel a lot.
He has to travel a lot. Very good. He has to travel a lot. Now let's go with number 11, Daniela. You
have to no vi qué más decía después. Go to, quiero ver. You have to do.
Uh-huh. Is that correct? You I have to do the ironing.
It's okay.
Okay, what about the others? What do you think? ¿Está bien así?
Is you don't have.
You don't have to do the ironing. I'll do it for you. I love ironing. You don't have to. Don't have to. You don't have to do the ironing. I'll do it for you.
Le está diciendo que lo hará.
Que no lo haga ella, que no es necesario. Right? Que no tiene que. Exactly. And the last one. Carolina, Teresa can see very well. Katia?
Teresa can see very well, so she has to wear glasses.
Very good. She has to wear glasses. Glasses. Right. Very good. Do you have questions about this exercise? Hoy nos toca práctica, así que vamos a hacer varios ejercicios. ¿Tienen preguntas? ¿No? Ok.
¿Ya copiaron las respuestas? ¿Sí? Ok, let's continue.
I only have to have clear. For, always we have to use for negative form, don't have.
Don't have to or doesn't have to. Dependiendo del sujeto. Va a utilizar don't have to or doesn't have to. Okay, another teacher, question.
Teacher.
Yes?
When use she, he, and it, use have to and doesn't have to.
Has to. Has to.
Has to.
Has to. She has to. Caroline doesn't have
and
to.
Has to.
Mm-hmm. Sí es.
But, she, right here, but right here it doesn't have to. Number four.
Caroline doesn't have to clean. Yeah, that's correct. Because we're using, remember, Ana, when we're using that.
Yes, yes. It's different. Yes, yes.
When we're using that, the verb goes back to the original form. So we cannot say doesn't has. No, we need to use doesn't and then we use have. But if it is in affirmative, we own in, we are not using does, we use the verb like this, has to. Very good. Thank you, Marina. Thank you, Anna. Another question? ¿Se entendió, Marina? Sí.
Yes. 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 Me cuesta, okay. De verdad me cuesta a mí.
¿Qué parte le cuesta?
Digamos, cuando leo las oraciones, por ejemplo, en la 4, Carolina is she. Uh-huh. Entonces, pues, sí, sí, pero esa parte sí la entendí. Como, digamos, en, si fuese positivo, pues has tú. Uh-huh. Carolina has to. Y aquí,
como es negativo.
Como es negativo, vuelvo doesn't y lo convierto a have to, por así decirlo.
Uh-huh. Exactamente. Uh-huh.
Pero sí me cuesta, de verdad, teacher.
Entonces vamos a hacer práctica.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Okay,
thank you.
Perfect. Thank you. Now let's continue here, guys, right, with our next exercise. We have this exercise here. Can you see the table? ¿Pueden ver una tabla? This is activities, Lisa and Tom.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, very well. Yes. It says here that we make sentences explaining what Lisa and Tom have to do or they don't have to do, right? So this is number one. Activities, make a K. Number two, do the homework. Wash the car. Walk the dog. Study history. Set the table. Cut the grass. Tidy the room. So what you're going to do, we're going to work in pairs, right? And you're going to make your examples. So you can say here, activity number one, Lisa, okay? Lisa has to make a cake. Tom doesn't have to make a cake. We're going to sound a little bit repetitive, but I want you to practice, okay? Lisa has to make a cake. Tom doesn't have to make a cake, right? Based on the activity number one. And you're going to do the same with the others. So number two, three, four, until eight, okay? Is it clear what we're doing right now? This is number one. Ya la respuesta la número uno la tenemos. Nos queda solamente, right? The questions for number two to number eight. ¿Alguna pregunta?
Yes, could you explain me what it means, tidy the bedroom?
Tidy the bedroom is organize everything and clean everything in the bedroom or in the room, in the kitchen, in the house, so it looks pretty nice. Clean everything carefully, organize everything. That is tidy the bedroom.
Lisa has to make a cake. Lisa, yes. Tom doesn't have
to make a cake. Okay, another question? So we have make a cake, do the homework, wash the car, walk the dog, study history, set the table, cut the grass, tidy the bedroom, right? That's what we have. Copy the first example and we're going to work in groups. Vamos a trabajar en pareja rapidito, right? To make our example. ¿Ya tienen captura de esa actividad?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, okay. We're going to work in pairs, right? So let's go. Okay, let's go right now, please. Select your groups. Selecten sus grupos. Vamos, vamos, vamos. Euseda, Katia, Fátima.
¿Qué tal? ¿Todo bien?
¿Tienen preguntas, bye. Katia, Leonel?
My person, not teacher.
No, okay.
¿Cómo? Okay, Katia. La primera sería... Lisa, ¿tú?
Lisa,
do the work, homework.
Do has to do homework.
To the homework. Falta el de.
To.
Lisa has to. Ay, ay, ay.
Y sería igual con cómo se llama, con Tom, ¿verdad? Tom has to do the homework.
Ahí sería igual, ajá. Tom has to do the homework.
Sí. Number three.
La tres. Ay, ay, ay. Me apago esto.
Lisa.
Ahí sería, ahí sí sería have to.
Pero okay, el ejemplo. Yes. Sí, pero el ejemplo que vimos decía Tom doesn't have. Entonces no sería en la 3.
Have to don't.
Lisa doesn't.
¿El don't? En Tom también, ¿verdad? Sí. Has to do the homework.
Has to do the homework.
Lisa has to walk. To walk.
Walk the dog.
The dog. Walk the dog.
Uh-huh.
Y aquí sería Tom. Doesn't. Walk the dog.
Walk the dog. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Walk the dog. La otra sería
Lisa
Lisa has to. No.
No, aquí no, no sería.
Es que, o sea, el have es para la tercera persona, ¿verdad? Have. Pero al convertirla en negativa, ese verbo ya no cambia, ya no cambiaría a has, sino que se mantendría en have porque utiliza los auxiliares don o dasen.
Exactly.
Me está explicando que ahí me confundo yo.
La acaba de explicar súper bien esta niña.
Gracias. Sí, sí, Ana, sí.
Sí, ahora seguía sí. Study the story.
Ajá, entonces Lisa es no y Tom es yes. Entonces sería Lisa, como es tercera persona, entonces utilizamos el auxiliar dasen, ¿verdad?
Dasen.
Ajá, por ser tercera persona. Entonces ahí no vamos a utilizar el verbo have, sino que have, porque ese no cambiaría. Have to.
The bedroom. Y Tom
has to
tidy.
The bedroom.
Ajá. Ahí estamos, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Hi.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, yo solo ando yendo por aquí. We're finished.
We're finished.
Yes. Casi todos. Solo un equipito nos falta. Okay. See you in a moment.
Entonces, están los nombres, Lisa y Tom. En el caso de Lisa, dice que sí y Tom no. Entonces, la teacher puso aquí arriba un ejemplo. Quiero ver si puedo manchar esto. Aquí dice, Lisa has to make... Ok, vamos a estar ocupando el has to...
Ah, o sea, de, con eso hacer dos oraciones. Una que sí, el reconoce.
Ajá, correcto. Así como el ejemplo que es aquí arriba, donde dice...
Exacto, en el segundo caso. Ajá.
No sé, teacher. Esa no es exacta, la teacher.
En el segundo. Ponele el...
Ajá, en el segundo. Yo tenía duda con el segundo, porque como ambos son yes and yes,
entonces yo había puesto... El... Do the homework. Entonces puedes decir Lisa and Tom. Ellos dos, de un solo una oración.
Ah, correcto, así la hice. Lisa and Tom have to do the homework.
Ajá, exacto. Para mí así ajá. Es.
Entonces, aquí la dejo para que...
Ay, vaya, hagámoslo.
Vaya. Entonces, la primera prácticamente ya está hecha por la teacher, la primera.
Ajá.
Entonces, la segunda dijimos que iba a ser Lisa and Tom have... To do the homework.
Ajá.
Ve. ¿Está copiando? Sí.
Uh-huh. Sí, estoy bien.
Ok. La tercera dice, wash the car. Lisa dice wash que no, car. Y Tom sí.
Ah, entonces ahí tenemos que poner, Lisa
uh-huh.
has.
No, como doesn't.
Lisa have doesn't have. Ajá.
Have. Uh-huh.
Doesn't have wash the car.
Mm-hmm. Have to wash the car.
No. Doesn't have.
Es que estamos ocupando have to.
No, pero si es como dice no, it doesn't have.
Pero sería doesn't have to, así como el ejemplo que es aquí, mire.
Tom, ajá, doesn't have to. Ay, Dios, ya terminó la teacher.
Todavía quedan como 40 segundos.
Ah, ok. Uh-huh. Es que ella estaba en una llamada, por eso no.
Ah, ok.
Quiero ver, de ahí vamos por las 4. Dice, walk the dog. Yes and no. Sería, Lisa has to walk the dog. Tom doesn't have to do. No, perdón. Tom doesn't have to walk the dog. Le damos captura por algo. Aide.
Okay, guys. So let's share the answers, right, for this exercise. Give me a moment. Okay. Can you see right now the computer? Yes, okay, very good. Now let's do number two. Aide, number two.
Number two, Lisa and Tom have to do the homework.
Lisa and Tom have to do the homework. That's correct. Very good. Thank you. Thank you, Aide. Veronica, number three.
Lisa doesn't have to watch the car. Tom has to wash the car.
Tom has to wash the car. Very good. Joanna, number four.
I'm sorry. Lisa has to walk the dog and Tom doesn't have to walk the dog.
Doesn't have to walk the dog. Very good. Number five, Marisela.
Lisa doesn't have to study history. Tom has to study history.
Tom has to study history. Very good. Alexis, number six.
Number six, Lisa doesn't have to set the table, and Tom doesn't have to set the table.
Okay, they don't have to set the table. Very good. Anna, number seven.
Number seven, Lisa doesn't have to cut the grass. Tom has to cut the grass.
Tom has to cut the grass. Number eight, Gerardo.
Lisa and Tom has to tidy the bathroom.
Lisa and Tom has to tidy the bedroom.
Tidy the bedroom. Okay.
Lisa and Tom. What subject pronoun is that?
They.
They have to.
Don't. Sería. Sería entonces como son ellos, sería dumb.
No, porque no es negativo. No. Ahí dice yes.
Ah, perdón, es have to tidy the bedroom.
Lisa and Tom have to tidy the bedroom. Very good. Remember that don't is only for negatives, right? Don't is only for negatives. Now, let's continue. We have the exercise correctly here, right? Do you have questions about that exercise? ¿Tienen preguntas? No?
No, teacher.
Okay, well, let's continue. We're going to do some talking right now, and you're going to tell me, I want you to think about this. Right. Look at the question. What are some obligations at your work? What are some obligations at your work? I'll give you 1 minute to think about two obligations. Think about two obligations right now. I'm going to think about mine too. Right. What are your obligations at your workplace? Oof, there are many things. their obligations, right? In my cases, one obligation is that I have to keep my camera on. I have to keep my camera on. There's an obligation. I have to.
I have to answer all emails.
I have to answer all emails. That's perfect. That's good, Gerardo. Another person?
I have to stay at 7 a.m. at work.
Okay, I have to stay at 7 a.m. at work. Okay, I would say I have to be. I have to be at 7 a.m. at work. Very good, Anna. What's another one?
Teacher, I supervise the production.
I have to supervise the production. Remember, we're talking about an obligation. When we use obligation, we're using have to. Right? So repeat again, Edwin.
Yes, teacher. I supervisor has to.
No, utilize have to.
I has to supervisor the production.
Okay. I have to supervise the production or the produce, como usted le quiera decir, right? I have to supervise the production. Repeat.
I have to supervise the production.
Okay, thank you so much. ¿Qué más tiene obligaciones? A ver.
Richard.
Yes.
In my case, every Monday, I have to meet with my boss in a conference call.
Excellent. Very good. I have to meet with my boss in a conference call. That's great. What about the others? The demás? Ejemplos?
Teacher, I have to call the clients.
I have to call the clients. Perfect. Thank you, Karen.
Mm-hmm. Teacher.
Yes.
I have to answer the emails.
I have to answer the emails. Excellent.
In my case, I have to be at 7:30 every day. And I have to update account statement.
I have to update the accounting statement. Accounting.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, teacher.
Thank you. Aide?
I have to prepare report every Friday with result the department.
Very good. Daniela?
I have to answer the client's calls and emails.
In emails. Brenda? Yes, Daniela? Daniela quería decir otra cosa.
No.
No, okay.
Only that.
Only that, okay. Brenda?
I have to supervise my salsa store.
Okay, very good. Katia, Maricela?
I have to check the email all time, and I have sent the document for customs.
For customs.
Customs. Very good.
Katia?
Cool. Wear my uniform correctly.
I have to wear my uniform correctly. Very good. I have to wear formal clothes too. Right? Yo por mí en camiseta estoy bien. And Verónica, tell me, Verónica.
I have to check the documents.
I have to check the documents. Good. So we have there, right, different examples of obligations at your workplace. Now we're going to do another exercise here. It says match. Match means connect, right? Put together, assemble, right? Now it says number one, we're going to put the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 connected with A, B, C, D, E. It says, I want to go to London. Estamos practicando need to ahorita. I want to go to London. We need to use the lift. You need to wait at the waiting room. I need to go to the ticket office. I need to take the 210 train. She needs to buy a new one. Those are the options. No sé cuáles son las respuestas. Veamos. Y díganme si hay alguna palabrita que no entendamos. Creo que la primera sería esta palabrita. Lift. Right. The lift is the elevator. El elevador. Right. When there are too many stories, hay muchos pisos. Right. We use the lift or the elevator. The lift, the elevator is the same. Okay. Creo que esa es la única palabra nueva. Y todas las demás estamos bien. Creo. Si no, díganme, por favor. Si no entienden alguna palabrita. Enciendan sus camaritas, recuérdense. Solo veo un par que encender sus camaritas. Solo 8 de los 14, ¿sí?
Suitcase. Este dulce, no, no sé qué es suitcase. Suitcase, no, no
suitcase.
Sé.
Suitcase. Suitcase. Yes. A suitcase. Let me show you here a picture of my suitcase. Suitcase is something that usually we use when we go to the office, right? And well, mostly men, you know, they use suitcases. Let me show you. Can you see my camera? I don't know if you can see it. This is a suitcase. This. When we go to the airport, when we go to the to the office with big stuff, we can wear one of these.
Okay.
This is a suitcase.
Ese tiene también un nombre, baggage.
Yeah. But baggage is the whole thing. Baggage is equipaje.
Equipaje.
Para traer su equipaje, usted necesita un suitcase. For you to carry your baggage, you need to have a suitcase. Okay.
It's not the same if you use bag.
No, it's not the same. For example, I can tell you that you can say this is a bag. This is a bag, right? Just because you have this like this, this will be a bag, right? Also, the ones that we wear when we go to the mostly women, right? We wear bags. Right. We wear bags, right? So that's another option, right? But it's not the same, right? Bags will be like this, more fancy, more fashion. And these ones, right? These ones to carry things that we buy every day. Otherwise, we're gonna have something like this, right? Sorry. Oh my God. Let me show you, I think. Can you see them? These are bags. These are bags right there.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Just let me do something right now. Do you finish with the matching?
No, teacher.
There are a lot of mosquitoes today. Gerardo, you finished? Okay, Valle, Valle de Molina. Okay, Brenda.
Yes, Daniela.
Marina.
No, no finished, teacher.
Not yet, okay.
Not Karen? Yet.
Not yet?
Yes, sure. Teacher. Okay. Finished, teacher.
Jonathan, sure. Yes?
Sorry,
sorry, no, yet.
No le escuché que me dijo, hable más fuerte.
Sorry, ¿qué íbamos a hacer?
We need to match the phrases.
I want to fight. Ah. I want.
Verónica, Sandra, Cristela, did you finish?
No, teacher. Yes, teacher.
Okay. We're going to check right now the answers. La mayoría ha terminado, entonces vamos a ir avanzando. Okay, pay attention to the answer. It says, I want to go to London. What's the answer, Daniela? I want to go to London.
I mean, you need to take the 210?
The 210 train.
Or 210 train.
Okay, I want to go to London. I need to take the 210 train. Very good. Todavía no sé la respuesta, veamos todas las demás. Ana, she wants a new tablet.
She needs to buy a new one.
She needs to buy a new one, okay. Verónica, our suitcase is very heavy. Our suitcase is very heavy.
We need to use the lift, life, no sé, lift.
We need to use the lift. Okay, we need to use the lift. Juana, the train is late. The train is late.
You need to wait at the waiting room.
Okay, you need to wait at the waiting room. Okay, Gerardo, I want to buy a train ticket.
I need to go to the ticket office.
I need to go to the ticket office. Well, actually, all of your answers in this case, they are correct, right? They are correct, but I need you to practice pronunciation too. Fatima, can you read the first answer, number one? Completo.
Okay, I want to go to London. I need to take the 210 train.
Very good. Number two, Sandra Maricela.
She wants a new table. She needs to buy a new one.
Okay. She wants a new tablet. Repeat.
A tablet. She wants a new tablet. She needs to buy a new one.
A new one, very good. Aide, number three.
Our suitcase is very heavy. We need to use the lift.
We need to use the lift. Jonathan, number four.
The train is late.
No le escuchamos.
Sorry, the train is late. You need to wait at the waiting room.
Wait. You need to wait at the waiting room. Repeat it.
Wait. You need to wait at the waiting room.
Room. Okay. And number five. Please, Leonel.
Yes, teacher. I want to buy, perdón, I want to buy a train ticket. I need to go to the ticket office.
Okay, bye.
Buy, perdón.
I want to buy a train
ticket. I want to buy a train ticket.
Excellent. Very good. Any questions about this exercise? ¿Preguntas acerca de este ejercicio? Questions?
No, teacher.
No, no, teacher.
Okay. Pasemos a asistencia entonces, ya que son las 9. Right. Jonathan, Verónica, Jair, no olviden encender su camarita para la asistencia, por favor. Right. We're going to start right now. There we are. Ana Alicia Valle de Molina.
Presente.
Brenda Yamileta Estrada Torres.
Presente, teacher.
Daniela María Ramos Ramos.
Presente.
Edwin Leonel Ordóñez Velázquez.
Presente, teacher.
Fátima Joana Tejada Candelario.
Presente, teacher.
Gerardo Antonio Colocho Cordero.
Presente, teacher.
Aide de la Paz Santos Vázquez.
Presente, teacher.
Jair Adonis Martín Molina.
Presente.
Jonathan Alexis González Torres.
Presente, teacher.
Juana Cristela Euseda García.
Presente.
Carla Susana Mena Valencia. Katia Carolina Parada Trejo. Marina Vanessa Vázquez Romero.
Presente, teacher.
Miriam Arely Romero Luna. Sandra Maricela Cepeda Alfaro.
I'm here.
Santos Alberto Chicas. Teresa de Jesús Ramos Santos. Verónica Esmeralda Martínez Dueñas.
Presente.
Okay,
teacher, a mí no me mencionó.
No lo mencioné. Uy, qué tal. No. Karen Janet Cruz Valiente.
Presente, teacher.
Thank you. Sorry. Now we're going to continue working here, right? But right now, just let me show you here. Okay, we're going to go right now to our book, okay? Now, in our book, what we're going to do is the following. We're going to go to page, right now, this is page 27. Let me show you here. Ya les muestro acá el libro. This page, right? When we're working with obligations or needs, right? And we have a conversation, right? We have with John and Anne. Now, Anna, can you help me out and be John? Aide, can you be Anne? Let's see your pronunciation. Veamos su pronunciación.
Oh my God. Okay. Can I start?
Yes, you are John.
Anne, is there something you need to do tomorrow?
Yes, actually, I need to call some clients. And you?
Well, I have to reschedule 2 meetings for tomorrow. They were canceled today.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yes, I have to provide important information to some customers.
That sounds interesting.
That sounds interesting. Very good. Aide, choose one person. And Anna, you choose another person. Karen.
Y yo escojo a ir a Donis Martínez.
Ok, thank you so much. Karen, you are Anne. Jair, you are John.
Ok.
¿Sí? Jair, ¿puede comenzar, por favor? Adonis. ¿Estás ahí?
Escojo otro, Miss.
¿A qué?
A Gerardo Antonio, vaya.
A Gerardo Antonio. Ok, Gerardo, you're John.
Ok. Is there something you need to do tomorrow?
Yes, actually, I need to call some clients. And you?
Well, I have to reschedule two meetings for tomorrow. They were canceled today.
Oh, bad.
Yes, I have to provide important information to some customers.
That's so interesting.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Now, would you say, for example, like this, oh, that's too bad. No? Es algo malo que pasó. Cualquier cosa que le hayan dicho que sea mala, usted puede utilizar esa frase. Se me terminó la comida. Oh, that's too bad. Se me acabó el saldo. That's too bad. Uy, no puedo ver Netflix. Me bloquearon la cuenta y me la paga. That's too bad, right? O cuando le dicen algo que suena interesante, aunque ustedes no crean que es interesante, a veces es importante tener estas frases, sobre todo para los jefes. That sounds interesting. That sounds interesting. Suena interesante, ¿verdad? Para demostrar que están poniendo atención. That sounds interesting. That sounds interesting. Suena interesante lo que me estás diciendo. No te creo, pero suena.
Así le vamos a decir a usted en la clase. That sounds interesting.
Oh, that sounds interesting, Sylvia. Now I'll be like, no, it doesn't. Okay, sí, se puede utilizar. Oh.
Finish the class. That's too bad.
Exactly. At 10 p.m. That's too bad. No tengo internet para el caso. Oh, that's too bad. No le van a pagar. Okay. Ok, very good. Entonces, para eso utilizamos esas frases. Right? Ahora ustedes pueden ver acá el uso de need to, have to, and have to. Right? En una situación, una conversación real. Right? Que nos puede pasar a todos. Now, let's continue. We already practiced how to use have to and need to. Ya sabemos cómo se utiliza, right? Ya lo explicamos el martes. But we're going to do this exercise. This is exercise 4 on page 27. Right? Write something you have to do or you need to do these days. For example, I'm gonna put here an obligation. That's for me, right? I have to check. I have to check the midterm. This is to ustedes, right? Esta es mi actividad. Miren, acá miren mi actividad, right? I have to check the midterm. When? On Friday. What time? At 10:15 p.m. Where? In the platform. No, in my house. In my house. Because I am here. Right? So at the end, I will have my sentence that will say, guys, I have to check the midterm on Friday at 10:15 p.m. in my house. ¿Miren? Tengo una oración más larga, right? ¿Cómo va a ser esa oración más larga? right? Voy a agregar lo que puse en when, cuando, what time, a qué horas, and where, en dónde, right? I have to check the midterm on Friday at 10 p.m. in my house, right? Complete sentence. Empecé con una obligación. I have to check the midterm. Y luego le agrego más detalles para hacer una oración más completa, right? ¿Se entiende qué es lo que vamos a hacer? Primero escribamos nuestra obligación y luego le vamos agregando más detalles utilizando estas tres preguntas. ¿Cuántas vamos a hacer? Vamos a hacer dos con have to y dos con need to. You are going to write two sentences with have to and two sentences with need to. ¿Ok? ¿Se entiende lo que vamos a hacer? ¿Se entiende lo que estamos haciendo?
Yes,
okay, Ana.
But for my example, it's I have to go to the supermarket tomorrow at 8 a.m. In
this case, you are going to be
in San Salvador.
In San Salvador, in my city, yeah. In my city or in San Salvador.
I don't have to say the exactly supermarket that I have to do to go.
No, that's not necessary. Mm-hmm. Unless you want to say it. I have to go to Walmart, right? For example, that would be specific.
Yes, or Super Selectos. Ah, that's good. Uh-huh. I can change the place, the location for the name of the super of the super.
Yes, for the proper name.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Now our examples here. I have my example. I will write another example with need to. Right, I'm gonna write here. I need to eat less carbs. This is mine. I need to eat less carbs. When? Every day, right? What time? At all times. So en todo momento, every day. At all times, where? In my house. Or I can put here, everywhere I go, I need to eat less. I need to eat less carbs every day, at all times, everywhere.
Miss, excuse me. Miss?
Yes?
Going back to my example. I was writing. I will tell you following the instructions. I don't think that sounds good. I have to go to the supermarket tomorrow at 8 a.m. Walmart. I have to change it. I have to go to the Walmart supermarket tomorrow at 8 a.m.
Yep. Okay. You can change here if you want to put where. You could put, for example, I have to go to Walmart tomorrow at 8 a.m. In Mexicanos. I think there's a Walmart there, right? In Mexicanos,
yes.
Right? Okay, did you finish your four examples? Solo cuatro van a escribir. Brenda?
Mm.
¿Lo tengo que decir o solamente?
Lo vamos a compartir en el chat. Si ya los tienen, escriban. Daniela, have you finished yet?
Teacher, can you remember mensualmente, monthly, ¿verdad?
Monthly, yes. Okay, Jair, ahora agréguele la información que tenemos. When, what time, and where. Eso le hace falta.
Teacher, ¿se la vamos a mandar por escrito?
En el chat, sí.
Okay.
Usually, Anna, when we say what time, usually we give like a specific time, right? It's more common. But your example is correct. I have to buy a pool next Friday. Right? It's solo el Friday con mayúscula. Right? Next Friday is todo bien. I have to go to the dentist with my daughter. Permítame que no aparece todo. I have to go to the dentist with my daughter. I have to go to the dentist on Saturday morning in Colonia Medica. Very good. I have to update accounting statements on Monday at 2 p.m. at the office. Mm-hmm. At the office. The office. Mm-hmm. I need to pay the electricity bill. Me too.
Me de la correct in the correction you already told me or say me. You said that I have to use uppercase in days of the week. Always.
Days of the week.
No matter if it's in the beginning, middle, or at the end of the.
Exactly. Days of the week, months of the year, and proper names. You too, Vanessa. On Sunday at 8 a.m. On Saturday. Monday, Gerardo, mayúscula. Sunday, mayúscula. Saturday, mayúscula. Verónica. Karen, esas comas están de más. No las escriba. No necesita comas.
Ok, teacher.
After PM at work. Very good, Ana. Very good, Karen, Verónica, Marina. Muy buenos ejemplos. Fátima, Gerardo. Very good. Santa Tecla va con mayúsculas, Gerardo. It's a proper name. Okay, now, do you have questions about this right now? Excellent, Cristela. Very good. Do you have questions? ¿Tienes preguntas?
Yes, Miss, I have. I'm sorry.
Go ahead. No, dele, dele, pregunta.
In Spanish, when you write the date, you use uppercase only when you write Monday, not when you add the months of the year. But in English, yes, you have to.
Yes, you have to. In Spanish, I'm not sure. En español, no sé, no le puedo confirmar ni negar lo que me acaba de decir. ¿Algún lingüista de español? Right, but in English, you have to use them. In English, it's necessary. It is a grammar rule, actually. All proper names, all months of the year, all days of the week, must have capital letters. Sandra, I have to go to work. ¿Me escucharon?
Ok, teacher.
Sí, ok, muy bien.
Sí.
Ana, ¿me escuchó? Es que siento como que se me trabó el internet. ¿Sí?
Yes, ma'am, thank you.
Ok, you're welcome. I'll listen to reports, Gerardo. Two reports. Lura. At a gas station. At a gas station. At a gas station. Okay, well, now we have the exercise. Let's move to another one. Recuerden que estamos en práctica, right? We're gonna do, we already did this. We did this, this. Now we're gonna do this exercise. Right, this is very simple, so we're going to do it together. Super fácil este ejercicio, así que lo vamos a hacer juntos. Right? Okay, Aidea, this is, I need to sleep right now in your house, dear sister, because I always go to bed before 11 p.m. Before 11 p.m. ¿Ok? Quítele el at. Y quítele la coma antes de because. Aide, ¿me escuchó? Aide de La Paz.
Yes, teacher.
Ok. I need to buy a computer in the Curaçao. She needs to travel to Spain, Karen. To Spain. Travel to. Siempre vamos a utilizar travel, que es viajar. Travel to a place. Travel siempre va con su hijito, que es to. Al igual que listen, va con su hijo, que es listen to. Travel to. A tiempo.
Ajá, tenía esa duda. Travel to también se, ah, o sea, se repite, por decirlo así, sí.
¿Por qué se va a repetir?
Es que como este, he puesto need to travel.
Sí, pero need to no tiene nada que ver con travel to.
Ah, ok, ok. Uh-huh.
Need to es una forma gramatical que va junto.
Uh-huh.
Entonces, recuérdense que ustedes to. En inglés, esto es para todos. Esto no solo es para Karen, esto es para todos. Van uh-huh. a haber preposiciones que se van a repetir. Recuérdense que hay preposiciones que pueden ser de lugar, de tiempo, ¿right? Entonces, van a tener diferente función. Por ejemplo, cuando decimos need to, ¿right? Es esa preposición de to va a ir como para hacer que funcione el infinitivo. Y la otra, travel to, esa es una preposición de lugar, que nos está diciendo que va a haber un viaje hacia un lugar. Es una preposición de movimiento. ¿Okay? Tienen un significado distinto. La palabra se escribe igual. Se pronuncia igual, pero tiene distinto significado. Así que no tengan miedo de utilizar la misma palabra en la misma oración. ¿Okay? Por ejemplo, si yo digo...
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Si yo digo, por ejemplo, acá... Miren, vamos a usar el futuro porque para que veamos el ejemplo. Si yo digo, I am going to travel to Spain to visit my best friend and to meet my pen pal. Right? ¿Cuántos tú tengo ahí? ¿Cuántos tú tengo?
Tres. Three.
Right?
Cuatro.
I have four. I have one here, right, that says, I am going to travel to Spain to visit my best friend and to meet my pen pal, right? Cada uno tiene un distinto significado, right? Cada uno va con su, en inglés hacemos de una oración, ¿se han fijado que les digo siempre? Hagan sujeto, verbo, complemento, right? Esos son pedazos de oración. Dentro de la oración las vamos a dividir y cada quien va a tener su frase. Right? Entonces aquí lo vamos dividiendo. Así que miren, hay cuatro. Listo, está bien. La oración está perfecta. No hay ningún problema. Right? Entonces no tengan miedo, aunque se equivoquen. Ustedes escríbanlo y después vamos viendo. Dicen, tal vez no es así, pues vamos a irlo remediando. Ahora, veamos este error acá. Este error, perdón. Is that I have to go with my son on Sunday at the mall, to the mall. Because we need to buy clothes for him. Very good. Cuando usted dice clothes, Gerardo, es, perdón, Jonathan, es esto. This is a cloak. These are clothes. A piece of fabric where you can clean. That's a cloth. Those are clothes, right? Estos. Pero si queremos decir ropa, tenemos que decir clothes or clothing. A mí me sale mejor pronunciar clothing. Me cuesta menos, entonces yo digo clothing. Pero las dos significan lo mismo. Okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Very good. Now, let's check the answers for this exercise. Can you see the exercise on the screen right now? Just circle the correct answers. Daniela Maria, what is the answer for number one? It says, we have to answer the questions. What's the answer?
We have to answer the question.
We have to answer the questions. Have to. Very good. Now let's see, Euseda. Emma has to have to go to the studio. What's the answer? Euseda? Ana.
Yes.
What's the answer for number two?
Emma has to go to the studio.
Excellent, thank you. Fatima, number three. Has to or have to?
Do you have to leave now?
Excellent. Do you have to leave now? Very good. Number four, Brenda.
Sería no, I don't have to.
No, I don't have to. Very good. Number five, Edwin.
Yes, teacher. Sería Jay. Doesn't have to wait for Emma.
Doesn't have to wait for Emma. Doesn't have to wait for Emma.
Wait for Emma.
Excellent. And number six, what's the answer, Marcela?
He have to help carry.
This one?
Yes.
Is that correct, Annie?
He has to help carry.
He has to, okay. Very good. He has to help carry. Mire, ese se parece, Karen, carry. Al verbo, pero es carry como un name, como un nombre, como la película de terror, carry. He has to help carry, right? Okay, recuérdese que con he, she, and it va a utilizar has. Okay, Marisela? Con you, we, they, and I, you, we, and they va a utilizar have. Do you have a question about this exercise? Welcome, Teresa. Welcome to the class. Bienvenida a la clase, Teresa.
Thank you, teacher. No me voy a conectar.
Pero ya se conectó, ya pudo.
Yes. Okay.
¿Preguntas acerca del ejercicio, chicos y chicas? ¿No? Seguimos practicando entonces. Vamos. Vamos, vamos, vamos. Tenemos este ejercicio. Right here. It's an exercise in which we have to, this is a conversation, okay? Now, we have a conversation between Ramón and Lara. We're going to do it right now together, right? Vamos a hacerla juntos. Porque después de esto, ya que tienen dos ejemplos de conversaciones, van a hacer la suya, propia, de ustedes. Van a hacer la suya, right? So we have Ramón. It says, hurry up. What do we have to put there, Gerardo? Hurry up.
Hurry up es como darse prisa, ¿verdad?
Hurry up.
We have to get ready to leave.
We have to get ready to leave. Have to hurry up. Apúrese. Right?
Apúrese. Come on, hurry up.
Come on, hurry up. Exactly. Hurry up. We have to get ready to leave. Leave? Where are we going? To the stadium. Don't you remember? No. Ana, you really listen to Carrie.
You really have to listen to Carrie.
You really?
Has to.
Okay. Sandra, is this correct?
You really have to.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. You really have to. Right? You really have to listen to Carrie. I do. Is Emma coming with us? Not today. She, I did.
go shopping and Lucy go, no. Today, Jim.
Is Emma coming with us?
She has to go shopping and buy some gifts.
She has to go shopping, right? She's not coming with us. Not today. She has to go shopping and buy some gifts. Aren't you going to buy any gifts? Brenda, aren't you going to buy any gifts? Number four.
I both own meal yesterday, so I have to buy any more.
I have to buy any more. Positive. Okay. Look at this. Aren't you going to buy any gifts?
No, I don't have to.
Don't have to, exactly. I don't have to buy, right? I bought all mine yesterday, so I don't have to. Ayer compré. Todo lo que necesitaba, ayer lo compré. I bought all mine yesterday, so I don't have
to. It was the meaning of
all mine, todos los míos. All mine, todo lo mío. Mine, this water is mine. This is mine. Very good. All right, Karen. Well,
I have to get something for Alex.
I have to get something for Alex. Well, I have to get something for Alex. Well, do that later. Do that later. We, Marina?
We have to.
We have to
go now or will be late.
Or will be late. We have to go now or will be late. Very good. Please don't tell Carrie I didn't remember. She, Veronica? Don't tell Carrie I didn't remember, Veronica.
She has to.
No, don't tell Carrie. Don't tell Carrie I didn't remember.
She doesn't have to.
Doesn't have to. Exactly. No le digas. ¿Para qué? No necesita saber. She doesn't have to know. ¿Para qué? No hay problema. Okay, but let's go, right? We have a conversation right now, right? Using have to and has to, don't have to, and doesn't have to. Miren la conversación, díganme si tienen preguntas de pronunciación, significado, estructura gramatical. Si tienen dudas, hagamos. ¿No hay preguntas?
Teacher, Harry up, ¿cómo se pronuncia? Harry up.
Hurry up, hurry.
Ho. Ho. Harry.
Hurry up.
Hurry up.
Okay. Hurry up. Hurry up, Teresa. Finish the exercise. Hurry up. Another question? Pregunten, no se queden con las dudas, por favor.
Teacher, I bought all my yesterday. Bought?
Compré.
Ah.
Es el verbo buy. Buy es un verbo irregular.
Uh-huh.
Entonces, cuando pasa a pasado, valga la redundancia, ahí cambia todo su deletreo de la palabrita, la cambia. que no va a ser bite, va a ser but. Por ejemplo, I buy chocolate. I buy chocolate every Monday. I buy chocolate every Monday. I bought chocolate. I bought chocolate last Monday. Compré chocolate el lunes pasado. Last Monday. Right?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Bye, bye. Very good. Another question? No? Seguimos? Shall we continue?
Teacher.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Manina?
¿Verdad que I didn't remember? Es como...
No me acordé.
No, ajá.
No me acordé, okay. Niña. I didn't remember.
I didn't remember. Okay.
¿Y trajiste la comida? ¡Ah! I didn't remember. ¿Hiciste la tarea? I didn't remember. Right? I didn't
Thank you, teacher. Remember.
You're welcome. Now, we're going to do right now, right? An exercise in which you are going to create a conversation. This conversation, it can be about your work or about your life in your house, okay? Any situation in your life. But you have to express necessity and obligation. Deben expresar necesidad y obligación. Entonces, en el campo laboral hay más opciones de donde tomar, right? So, you're going to write this conversation. It's not going to be a long conversation. Right. No tiene que ser una conversación larga, puede ser una conversación como esta, right? O puede ser una conversación como esta. Siempre utilizando need to y have to. Ambos. You're going to use either. Right? You are going to use either. Not only one. This conversation is going to be in pairs. Solo nos quedan 15 minutos. Entonces, vamos a comenzar la conversación. Hoy vamos a tratar de terminarla porque es casi imposible que ustedes se reúnan aparte para hacer una conversación. La vamos a terminar hoy y la practicamos mañana. ¿Ok? Todavía nos faltan más ejercicios. Entonces, vamos a hacer la conversación hoy. ¿Se entiende qué es lo que estamos haciendo? ¿Sí? O lo que pretendemos hacer, mejor dicho. Very good. El setting, el escenario de la conversación puede ser su trabajo o su hogar. Ustedes van a decidir en el equipo que van a estar. Right? So let's start. Recuérdense con quién están trabajando porque con esa misma persona van a trabajar mañana. Right? Solo va a haber un equipo de tres. De ahí los demás vamos en pareja. Let's go. Permítanme, vamos a ver que no hay ningún relajo. Yes. Let's go. Let's go. La moví.
Ah, vaya.
La moví porque se fue alguien y Fátima se quedó sola.
Ah, vaya.
Pero ya estamos bien.
Okay.
Ajá, ladies.
Ajá.
Mañana la vamos a discutir.
¿Y debemos de incluir las de ambos o elegimos a uno y hacemos las obligaciones de ese?
Coja solo uno.
Como es una conversación, ajá, puede ser ahí de uno.
De uno, ¿verdad?
Puede ser, ajá, del trabajo suyo o del mío. ¿Dónde trabaja usted? Vamos a ver.
Yo trabajo en una fábrica.
Ah, pues esa vamos a usar.
Vale. ¿Dónde trabaja usted?
Yo trabajo en una zapatería.
Ya veo, zapatos.
A todos les emociona cuando les digo que trabajo en una zapatería.
Zapatos.
Vale. Ajá. No, es que vaya. I need to know about your work. Ahí te digo, necesito saber acerca de tu trabajo. Tell me, what do you do? Dime, ¿qué haces?
Yeah. I have to supervise.
Espérame, lo voy a ir anotando para que después lo mande de una sola. I have to
supervisor the production.
I have to supervise the production.
¿Quién más está con nosotros?
Teresa.
Teresa.
Entonces, vaya, la primera, yo voy a hacer la pregunta, Gerardo. El segundo, Leonel, va a contestar, ¿verdad?
Ajá, y después puedo ser yo o tú decirle, en you, Teresa.
Ajá. En you, Teresa, ajá. Ahí tú, I had two supervisors of the production, en you, Teresa. En you, Teresa.
I have check email every day in the morning. And supervisor the project.
The project.
I have to check the email every morning.
Every day in
every
the morning.
Day. Every day in the morning. Uh-huh.
And supervisor the project.
And supervisor the project.
I do
homework with you.
I need to homework
for tomorrow.
We do for tomorrow.
Y entonces usted me puede decir really o como
o algo así como es, no creo, ¿cómo sería?
I don't pay attention.
I don't pay attention.
Okay. Ah, okay, voy a contestar, te voy a decir, okay, I did. I don't like sweet bread.
¿No te gusta?
No.
La semita pacha.
sweet
bread. Sweet bread, yeah. Or dessert. O postre. Dessert, sweet bread, pan dulce.
Okay, okay, Aide. I don't like sweet bread. I prefer coffee.
I prefer only coffee.
Coffee. Uh-huh.
I don't like coffee. Only coffee. I drink coffee with a sweet bread.
Sweet bread. Okay.
Yo digo que está ahí,
¿verdad? Para no confundir.
Podemos seguir, ¿cómo, Lela? Eso fue hace poquito, ¿no?
Ajá.
Vaya, después, después me toca hablar a mí. ¿Cómo qué más puedo decir?
before to answer, I need to verify.
Yo pensaba, por ejemplo, podemos preguntar, no sé, o sea, ¿qué necesitas en tu trabajo? ¿Qué necesitas?
Yo necesito verificar antes las guidelines antes de responder, porque de eso depende la respuesta que yo le voy a dar al customer. Entonces, sería, I have to check the emails, podría ser. Tengo que verificar mis correos. Después, sería, after, I have to answer the emails. But before they answer the email, I need to verify the guidelines. Es como un trabalenguas, pero es así el orden, porque sería, primero tengo que verificar los correos, después responderlos, pero antes de responderlos tengo que verificar las guidelines para ver el proceso. Before I need to verify the guidelines to know what is the process, podría ser.
Sí, no, está bien. Entonces yo ahí puedo decirle a Teresa what else, ¿cómo se dice más? ¿Qué más hace? Do you do?
Quiero ver. ¿Qué más hace?
What else?
What else do you do?
Well, uh-huh. What else do you do?
What else do you do?
At work. Yo le pregunto a Teresa. Teresa, mm-hmm. What else do you do at work?
What else do you do at work?
Ya vete ahí el need to. Y luego ya me pregunta a mí, yo meto.
No sé, pero no sé si anotaron bien lo que yo les dije. Para.
La verdad, no.
Vaya, se lo voy a dictar otra vez.
Lengua, bien.
Ajá, pero es que la conjugación de la oración, I have to check the email. Se lo voy a decir despacio. I have to check the emails.
Uh-huh.
I need to verify the guidelines.
I need to
verify the guidelines. Guidelines es como, se lo voy a dictar, guide, G-U-I-D-E, y junto va L-I-N-E, guideline, con S, guidelines.
Ajá.
Tengo que revisar el correo electrónico y necesito verificar las guidelines. The guidelines of the step to, no, the guidelines, así le, to provide a troubleshooting, but, to provide the troubleshooting. Trouble, se escribe trouble, shoot. Troubleshooting, to provide the troubleshooting. I have to check the email and I need to verify the guidelines to provide the troubleshooting.
Ay, no, ya no va. No va a salir, no, no.
¿Todavía no? A ver.
Entró. Y luego tú me...
Tenemos una pregunta. Dígame. Para decir, ¿a dónde vamos? Está bien, where we go.
Where are we going? ¿A dónde vamos? Where are we going?
Ay, ya decía yo que nos hacía falta la pregunta. Pero sería, ¿are we going?
Going. Where are we going? No andábamos tan perdidas.
Uh-huh. Un poquito, nada más.
I have a good idea. Let's go, Metrosen. Y de ahí podemos poner como qué tipo de zapatos quisiéramos. ¿Verdad?
Ajá.
¿Qué me ocurre?
sería, sería what kid, la palabra que utilizamos, kids, ¿verdad? What kinds, K-I-N-D-S.
Ajá.
¿Sí?
¿Y what kind?
What kinds, ¿qué tipo?
What kind of shoes? What kind of shoes?
Need to. Necesita, no.
Do you need to?
Do you have?
Puedes el tiempo presente.
¿Cómo era? Ya se me olvidó.
Yes. What kind of shoes do you
need to?
Do you need to?
Sí. Ah, pero ahí se desarmó, ¿verdad?
No.
Teacher, el need to. En preguntas iba al final.
Sí, ¿por qué no?
Acabo de tener una laguna. Disculpe.
Ay, hoy sí me voy a salir de aquí. Quiero que para que me vea. Ay, ¿qué hice?
Sí, pero sí, ya nos vamos a ir, chicas. ¿Ok?
Bueno. Creo que... Ay, Dios. ¿Qué hice, Dios mío? No la veo, Daniela.
Pero yo te oigo, no te preocupes. Ya te vi.
Y que no puede, no sé por qué no logro. Ay, Dios. Ya nos vamos a salir.
Ahí estás. Vaya. Nos quedamos en
What kind of shoes do you need to? Ajá. Ajá. Y para decir cualquiera es any way, ¿verdad? O decimos un especial. Sports.
Cualquiera. Sí.
O cualquiera.
Cualquiera es anything. Anything.
Anything.
Decimos, no, para, hacerla okay. Más, para hacerla más larga hay que elegir.
Digo. Vámonos.
Vaya pues. Chao.
Ok. Most of you already finished your conversation. La mayoría ya terminó la conversación. Mañana esa va a ser la primera actividad que vamos a realizar en la conversación. Así que con lo que tenemos, vamos a participar. Ok, that's what we're going to do for tomorrow. Right now, let me just call the attendance. Vamos a pasar asistencia.
Teacher.
Sí, dígame.
Mañana lo terminaríamos entonces.
Sí, podemos tomar los primeros 5 minutos para terminarlo. Después de pasar la asistencia y luego la practicamos okay. La conversación.
Okay.
Recuérdense con quién van porque lo voy a preguntar.
Sí.
Analicia Valle de Molina.
Presente.
Brenda Yamile de Estrada Torres.
Presente, dicho.
Daniela María Ramos.
Presente.
Edwin Leonel Ordóñez Velázquez.
Presente, dicho.
Fátima Joana Tejada Candelario.
Presente, teacher.
Gerardo Antonio Colocho Cordero. Aide de la Paz Santos Vázquez.
Presente, teacher.
Jair Adonis Martín Molina. Jonathan Alexis González Torres. Juana Cristela Euseda García.
Presente.
Karen Janet Cruz Valiente.
Presente.
Carla Susana Mena Valencia. Katia Carolina Parada Trejo. Marina Vanessa Vázquez Romero.
Presente, teacher.
Miriam Arely Romero Luna. Sandra Maricela Cepeda Alfaro.
I'm here.
Teresa de Jesús Ramos Santos.
Presente, teacher.
Verónica Esmeralda Martínez Dueñas.
Presente.
Okay, so we're gonna stop right there. Today is the day 4. 16, Jair Adonis Martín Molina. Like the other ones, I see you tomorrow at 8 p.m. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Good
night.
Bye, teacher.
Bye. No está Jair, por si alguien se quiere quedar.